Save your water with the help of Grass Alternatives. Courtney standing by with some low maintenance lawn options.
Yeah, we're going to check back in with Ed Zuckerman with Delta Bluegrass and learn a little bit more about harvesting and some more of the samples that you've got there. Hi, Ed.
Hi, thanks for having me back.
Sure. Now, you mentioned this in the last time that we chatted. Now, what are we looking at on the pallets here?
Well, this is freshly harvested Bermuda grass. It's been overseeded with ryegrass. The harvester that we use, you can see it in the background here, it's really loud, so I elected not to have it running because you wouldn't be able to hear me talk. But this is basically what we do on a daily basis. We harvest early in the morning, in the wintertime, in the summertime when it's hot, we'll harvest in the evening hours so it's freshly delivered to your job site. So this basically is a just one example of what we do. We harvest anywhere from 4 to 6 acres a day. So we have a fleet of four of these machines. And it keeps us busy, partly because we have so many varieties, some of which I'll show you over here if you want to follow me.
While we're walking over there, just a question for you. When you harvest, how quickly do you then replant or resod from harvest?
Well, on hybrid Bermuda, it's what we call re-veg. So it grows back. Because it's got stolons that are left in the ground. So it grows back after we harvest. On our cool season grasses like fescue, we seed those. We have two basic planting seasons, spring and fall.
Okay.
Pretty hot to be planting sod right now.
Yep.
So we take a little break in the summertime. So on the back of my pickup here, we've got three basic real good drought alternatives. This rangy looking roll right here is basically, it's basically our native Mofri, and it's meant to be laid down in a unmowed state. So we kind of keep it long, and once it gets on the job site, homeowners can leave it unmowed if they so desire. So it has much less of a carbon footprint, and the longer turf, it looks, gives a nice metal-like look. And there's not a whole lot of maintenance to it, and because it grows long, the water needs are nowhere near what a bluegrass lawn would be.
Okay.
In the center here is hybrid Bermuda.
Okay.
Which is what you just saw harvested, and over here on the right hand side of the truck is one of our newest drought alternatives. Doesn't look like grass because it's not. It's Lipia, and it's basically Carapia is what it's called. And it is our newest offering to the market. It's gotten a lot of traction. People really like it. It can be left mowed or unmowed. And it saves the water of about, you could put 50% of the water on this that you would put on normal turf grass.
Good to know.
It's a real good drought alternative.
So Ed, thank you so much for your time. Yeah, I was going to say, I'm looking behind you.
And thank you for
having
me.
You've got a lot more. We're going to link all the details to Delta Bluegrass to our website, gooddaysacramento.com, under show info and today's date. Acres and acres they've got to serve you. Thanks, Ed. Appreciate it. Cody,
thanks.
Back over to you.
Good Memorial Day to you all.
You as well.
Flagship stores.